Teachers across Ontario are dealing with job uncertainty this morning. The Peel Board, west of Toronto for one, is announcing it will have a staff surplus for the fall. Megan Fitzpatrick has been looking into that. She's at Queen's Park for us this morning, the Ontario Legislature. Some notices went out from the Peel Board, Megan. What do they say?
Yeah, a whole round of them yesterday, Heather, to both elementary school and high school teachers in the board. More than 350 of them have now been told that they do not have permanent positions come September. And the Peel Region School Board is saying that these layoff notices were given because of the upcoming changes in class sizes in Ontario, as well as a loss in funding. Now, it's possible some of these teachers might still find different jobs if other teachers retire or leave their positions, but there's no guarantee that the numbers will really line up. Now, the Ford government has said throughout all of these education reforms they've been bringing in that no teacher will voluntarily lose their job. Over the next 4 years, the Ford government plans on eliminating more than 3,000 teaching positions in the province, but they say that will all be through attrition. But what we're hearing from the Peel Region and other school boards is they are very concerned about a budget shortfall come September and are saying they don't see how teachers won't be laid off, Heather. And the education minister, Lisa Thompson, was asked about this apparent contradiction in question period here at Queen's Park yesterday by NDP leader Andrea Horvath. Take a listen to some of Thompson's response.
What's damaging right now is the fact that this party opposite is absolutely doom and gloom. And the fact of the matter is, this is an annual routine.
So she's saying it's normal at this time of year for school boards to be giving these kinds of notices as they prepare for the next year, given what teachers they have, what classes they'll be offering, how many students they anticipate having. And the school boards, though, important to note, they don't know yet, Heather, how much money they will be getting for the from the province for next year. I'm told they normally know that amount at this time, but they have not been given that funding envelope yet. The Ford government saying they will know that by the end of the month, but these school boards are very anxiously awaiting that funding, of knowing how much money they will get from the provincial government this year so they can plan for next year.
Okay, and as you say, the timing of all of this, just as the union set to begin bargaining a new contract, the whole question, labor unrest, the premier weighing in on this matter yesterday, talking about there should be no strike, there's no need to strike, as he sees it. What exactly is he saying to the teachers of his province?
Well, he repeated what the education minister said about there being no voluntary layoffs, and he's saying wait till the end of the month when the school boards know how much money they're getting, and then we'll talk. On the upcoming contract negotiations, Heather, he was asked if the teachers go on strike, if they can't come to an agreement, what will happen then? Would the Ford government legislate them back to work? He said, let's cross that bridge when or if the province and the teachers unions get to that point. But take a listen to what else he said about teachers in the province.
It's a pretty good deal that they have right now. They get their 3 months holidays. They have the best benefit package in the entire country, the best pension in the entire country, a health plan. What, like, they have a great gig, if you want to call it. They do a great job, by the way, and I appreciate all the teachers. But guys, don't pull the strike nonsense on the parents and on the poor students.
So he said his government's going to do everything possible to avoid that kind of scenario, Heather, but he's also saying that the unions have declared war on the province. So it's a pretty tense relationship right now between the province and the unions heading into those contract negotiations.
Megan, thank you very much. Megan Fitzpatrick from Queen's Park.